2010 is the International Year of Biodiversity, and biodiversity is the variety of nature in the world, the variety of life, and it's important for everything we do as humans, with all of our food and our wealth and our fuel ties into the natural world, and so we get it from. So this exhibition is just part of that celebration of world's biodiversity. Today we've been preparing a few hundred of our mice skeletons in jars for the exhibition in the Cloisters. We've been getting them out, putting them in jars, seeing what they can fit like so they can go on the shelves. They're from a collection of about 8,000, so we've had to select the prettiest ones. But they're all from different islands, from around the world, different species, different breeds, different sexes. And that can tell us a lot about the evolution and the ecology of mice. The mice skeletons are just one of the four cases in the exhibition. The other three are microfossils from the geology collections, jackal skulls from the Grant Museum of Zoology, and igneous rocks, also from the geology collections. You might look at some of these mice or some of the jackals, some of the microfossils, and say, at first glance, they look the same, but actually within each of those groups, there's a huge diversity. In the Grant Museum, there's about 67,000 different animal specimens from all across the animal kingdom. And by using these collections in teaching, both in the university and to the public and schools, we can say this is what the breadth of the natural world is, this is what it has, this is what each different species does, how it fits together, and how all of these things work together to make kind of the natural ecosystem.
This exhibition shows some examples of how we study biodiversity, and having multiple specimens of different species helps us understand why these species are different from each other, what are the different factors that allowed them to become different, or why they were selected for different features during the course of their evolutionary history. It helps us understand how these different factors play together to create the range of biodiversity that we see today and that we see in the past, and why that's changed over time and what might happen to it in the future.
I guess what microfossils allow us to do that other fossil groups don't allow us to do is to look at huge numbers of specimens and look for crucial differences. We can look at populations of literally thousands or millions of specimens, and that allows us to compare morphological differences that tell us things about species, the amount of differences between species, and how species change.
What I think people should take from this exhibition is really understanding that museum collections all across the world house the basic information that we need to understand the evolutionary process. We need to have multiple specimens, dozens or hundreds or thousands even in some cases, to really understand how evolution happens. And we can only do that by having large public institutions saving and preserving this information and making it accessible to scientists across the world.